Take a look at that sunset. Oh man, that's gorgeous. That beauty, believe it or not, wouldn't be possible without dust. That's right, dust. The stunning colors of sunsets, sunrises, and even our blue skies are made from light passing through gas molecules, as well as interacting with the dust and small particles in our upper atmosphere. And other times, it's cloudy and rainy, but dust gives us that too. And that's really only the beginning. We pretty much owe our lives to dust. So let's take a look. Hey everyone, I'm Patrick Jones, and welcome to Cheddar Explores. Gotta stretch. In our atmosphere, elements from meteors to dirt, sand, and pretty much anything else give us dust. In places like Sahara and Africa, dust made from dirt and sand is swept up into the atmosphere by strong winds. That dust from Sahara and Africa is thought to be a vehicle for nutrients like iron. Iron is critical for plant growth. The iron that blows off Sahara and Africa encourages growth in some otherwise barren places. It's thought to produce forests in Ghana, algae blooms in the Atlantic Ocean, and also helps rainforests grow in the Amazon. The Amazon might not be what it is without the influx of dust from Africa, and that's 3,000 miles away. All that's important, but now think about rain. Without dust in our water cycle, it wouldn't rain. You see, in order for water to fall to Earth, it has to weigh enough. Water vapor as a gas is too light. That's why it's in the atmosphere in the first place. Cooler air causes water vapor to condensate onto dust particles, and when it builds up enough, it creates rain. The amount of dust in our atmosphere is constantly changing, and right now, it's increasing. That could have major consequences for our environment. And you guessed it, it's our fault. Forests keep soil in the ground, but humans are cutting down those forests at a rate of 18.7 million acres a year. That means more dust is making its way into the atmosphere, thus creating more clouds. Because all clouds really are is water vapor that's starting to attach itself to dust in the air, it's just not heavy enough to fall yet. According to NASA, roughly 67% of the planet is covered in clouds, and that number could increase if dust continues to accumulate. Scientists are still determining the full scope of the problem, but it can have one of two consequences. It could either cool down the Earth or heat it up. A cloud, depending on its type or position in the atmosphere, can either block sunlight and create a cooling effect, or clouds can prevent heat from escaping the Earth, adding to the greenhouse effect. Solutions are scarce because there's still information we need to collect. Dust can also carry pollution. We know that dust can travel far distances and have consequences half the world away. Coal burned in China, for example, could cause acid rain in California. The world is more interconnected in that regard than we sometimes realize. Think about that next time you're sweeping your apartment. Hey guys, thank you so much for watching. If you liked what you saw, please like, comment, subscribe. We're making a lot of fun stuff here at Cheddar, and we hope you keep watching.